I first enter all collected data into a spreadsheet program, for example Excel, before transferring it into a statistics program, for example Minitab. This has the advantage that I can organize, sort and filter the data very comfortably. In addition, existing data from databases can be exported to Excel very easily. And here in Excel, I label the columns with meaningful variable names from the data collection plan. Many users insert additional data rows in Excel to format the table and make it clearer. In the statistics program, however, empty cells are regarded as missing data. Therefore, delete these empty formatting rows before you transfer them to your statistics program. Minitab issues an error message if columns linked in the same analysis do not have the same length. Therefore, delete unnecessary entries at the end of a column. Raw data of an Excel spreadsheet can either be copied and pasted directly into a Minitab worksheet or imported via the menu item File and Open. If you want to paste copied data, make sure you select the column label CN in Minitab and then paste. Otherwise, the Excel variable name will be the first data entry in the data row and you will get the variable name as data. This also means that the data type of this variable is automatically set to text, which corresponds to our nominal scale level. Minitab distinguishes three data types. Numeric, indexed in the column label in the first cell by CN, suitable for our ordinal and cardinal scale data. The data type text, CNT, is suitable for our attributive nominal scale data, and the additional data type datetime, CND, for time specifications. If numeric data is formatted as text in Excel, Minitab also displays it in text format and indexes it with a T in the column label. In this case, the data cannot be evaluated numerically. Therefore, numerical data represented in Minitab as a text variable must be reformatted either in Excel or with the command Data change data type in the Minitab menu. Some incorrect entries in Excel, such as an O instead of a 0, are indexed by Minitab with an asterisk as missing data. It is always a good idea to first correct the raw data in Excel and copy the corrected data back into Minitab, or import the complete file again. After data entry and correction of invalid and useless raw data, you can continue the plausibility check with graphical evaluations. The Pareto chart, suitable for nominal scale data, shows that the sample contains 50% chocolate cookies, 45% vanilla cookies, and 5% chocolat cookies. The chocolat cookie is again a data entry error, which I correct in the raw data before I continue my inspection. The histogram is suitable for cardinal and, with restrictions, for ordinal scale data. The Anderson-Darling test shows that this data is not normally distributed for the taste ratings of all cookies. We could now create separate histograms for chocolate and vanilla cookies to check the normality of the distributions, but that is not the purpose of the data inspection. To check the plausibility of the data, I look at the minimum and maximum values. They are in the expected range from 1 to 6, as determined in the data collection plan. Data below and above this range would again indicate invalid data.
I save the complete raw data from Excel in a Minitab worksheet. And I store filtered data from Excel in additional worksheets. Make sure you name all worksheets accordingly to keep track of them.